Suleiman the Magnificent. Between the years of 1520 to 1566, Suleiman the Magnificent reigned for 46 years. He was the longest reigning sultan in the history of the Ottoman Empire. It was during Sultan Suleiman's time that the empire had its largest borders. Suleiman had 13 major campaigns. He passed away at his last campaign at the age of 72. During his reign, the empire's legislative activities increased. Suleiman was born on the 6th November 1494 in Trabzon. His father was Prince Yavuz Sultan Selim, who later became Sultan. When Suleiman was Sancak Bey in Kefi, he learned Arabic, Persian and Tatar. He was also familiar with Slavic languages. He was a great hunter and loved to go on the hunt with his bow and sword. He even hunted some tigers and bears. In 1509, when Suleiman was 15 years old, he was appointed as Sancak Bey of Şebinkarahisar, but he was sent to Bolu because it was closer to the capital, Istanbul. When his father Selim became Sultan in 1512, he came to Istanbul and was named deputy governor of the Sultanate. In 1513, he was sent to Manisa as Sancak Bey. He came to the capital while his father was on campaigns. In 1520, when he got news that his father died, he headed to Istanbul and descended to the throne. Suleiman changed many laws and legislations to strengthen the empire. That's why he is also known as Kanuni, the lawmaker. Suleiman's first campaign was to Belgrade to spread further west. He needed to take Belgrade, something Mehmed the Conqueror was unable to accomplish. The Holy Roman Empire went to war with France in 1521. While they were at each other's throats, Suleiman took the opportunity to advance to Hungary and take Belgrade. After he took Belgrade, he turned Belgrade's biggest church into a mosque and performed the Islamic Friday prayer there. In order for Suleiman to take control of the Mediterranean region, he needed to conquer Rhodes. So in June 1522, a powerful Ottoman army set sail to Rhodes. It was a very hard siege. The Knights Hospitaller held the castle for a long time, but at the end they surrendered. They lost 5,020 men. The Ottomans lost between 8,000 and 12,000 men. Suleiman also executed the son of Cem Sultan who lived in Rhodes. In 1523, a Janissary revolt broke out in Istanbul while Suleiman was on a hunting trip. When Suleiman returned from the hunt, he executed the chief of the Janissaries and ended the revolt. In 1525, the French King Francis I was defeated by Charles V and was imprisoned. The French king's mother asked the Ottomans for aid. Suleiman saw this as an opportunity to conquer Hungary, to have neighboring borders with the Habsburgs. In 1526, Suleiman started his conquest of Hungary. He set off with an army of 100,000 men. They met the Hungarians at the Battle of Mohács. The Ottomans lost between 1,500 to 2,000 men, while the Hungarian losses were much higher. They lost approximately 20,000 men and their king Louis II died. After that, Suleiman returned to the capital. In 1529, Sultan Suleiman returned to Hungary to deal with Franz Ferdinand's German and Hungarian troops. On the 27th September 1529, he reached Vienna, the Habsburg capital. This venture caused great panic and fear in Europe. But the siege was ended after just 17 days by the Sultan. The reasons for this decision were that Vienna wasn't a direct goal. The second reason is that the Ottomans wouldn't have a proper hold of it. Suleiman also found out that Ferdinand wasn't in Vienna. The people of Vienna asked for mercy, plus the weather conditions were bad. In 1531, Ferdinand besieged Budin, forcing Suleiman back to Hungary. In 1533, Ferdinand sent an ambassador to Istanbul to ask for a ceasefire. In 1536, Sultan Suleiman executed his grand vizier and best friend Pagal Ibrahim Pasha. The reason behind this might be that Ibrahim got cocky and portrayed himself as the real power behind the Ottoman Empire. Furthermore, he used a variety of tactics to negotiate favorable deals with the leaders of the Catholic powers. After executing his best friend, Suleiman fell into a long depression. In 1531, Ferdinand besieged Budin again, forcing Suleiman back to Hungary. Suleiman captured important fortresses to secure the borders to the province of Budin. In Budin, Ali Pasha captured important fortresses and defeated the German force. Ferdinand started paying tribute to the Ottomans. The Ottoman forces were defeated in Malta in 1565. On May 1566, Suleiman set off for another campaign, even though he was very sick. Zigetvar was besieged by the Ottoman forces. The Ottoman forces had a hard time taking the fortress. At the end, the fortress was taken on the same day the Sultan died in his tent. The death of Suleiman was hidden until his son Selim II arrived. Now that we covered his western campaigns, let's take a minute to talk about his eastern campaigns. While Suleiman was busy fighting in the west, the Safavids on the east posed a threat. When Suleiman obtained peace in 1533 with the west, he sent his grand vizier Ibrahim Pasha. In 1534, Ibrahim besieged and took Tabriz. From there, he set off to Baghdad. But due to bad weather conditions, they got slowed down. They had to burn carriages and cannonballs to prevent them from falling into enemy hands. Ibrahim entered Baghdad on the 30th November. Sultan Suleiman advanced towards Shah Tahmasp. The Shah fled to Isfahan. When Suleiman saw that Tahmasp wouldn't meet him, he returned to Istanbul. In 1548, Suleiman advanced against the Shah, but he panicked and fled again. Suleiman captured one. The execution of Shahzade Mustafa. The people around Shahzade Mustafa, Suleiman's oldest son, spread rumors about the Sultan's well-being. Rustem Pasha and Hürrem Sultan wanted to get rid of Mustafa, and Hürrem wanted one of her own sons to ascend to the throne. In 1563, Suleiman started a campaign against the Safavids. When Suleiman was in Ereğli, the prince visited his father, the Sultan, but instead of his father, he found executioners waiting for him. He was then strangled to death. The Janissaries blamed Rüstem Pasha, who was then dismissed as vizier. In July 1553, Suleiman advanced towards Revan. He completely destroyed it, and after that he entered Nakhchivan. In 1555, Tahmasp sent an ambassador to Suleiman, who was in Amasya. The Ottomans and Safavids made peace. The Sultan appointed the world-renowned Barbaros Hayreddin Pasha as chief of the Ottoman navy. In 1535, during the campaign of Corfu, the Ottomans and the French worked together. The siege of Corfu was unsuccessful and was stopped by the Sultan. In 1538, Barbaros Hayreddin Pasha defeated his adversary Andrea Doria in Preveza. Barbarossa captured many islands in the Mediterranean. In 1553, the French and Ottoman navies captured Corsica. On the 6th September 1566, Sultan Suleiman died of natural causes. His body was brought back to Istanbul, while some of his inner organs were buried outside of Sivetgar in Turbek. A mausoleum was constructed above the burial ground. After Suleiman's death, his last living heir, Selim II became Sultan of the Ottoman Empire. Selim was the first Sultan who didn't lead the campaign himself, but instead sent his pashas on campaigns while he stayed in Istanbul. He also was the first Sultan who died in Istanbul.